We are blessed by Mother Nature. Nature invites peace and stillness. It uplifts my soul. A melody so relaxing, man, I imagine how life would be. We are blessed by Mother Nature.
Anyone here, respond by saying yes.
Oh my god, I'm not moving it. I'm not moving it.
Well, obviously I'm moving it, Danny. It's fake, man. God.
I think something actually happened.
Are you the one that didn't follow you? It wasn't a choice. I said he was alone.
Danny! Danny, what did I... Oh! What the...
Thank you.
everybody, I am back with another Minecraft video. Not on my watch. Get him. Get him. Get him. Alright guys, we're back and we made a couple friends, yeah!
go! Let's go! What are you doing? What are you doing?
truly love about nature is how present I become when I'm surrounded by it. It uplifts my soul. I receive its high vibrations and quickly come back to becoming my highest self, my best self. The harmony of the wind and nature note my soul with the rhythm of the frequencies I receive. Nature invites peace and stillness, entering a magical realm where the colors are bold and everything ugly becomes old. As it slowly kills my worries and stress, I look up to the blue skies and lay down my head. The grass and trees so green, the beautiful birds they sing. A melody so relaxing, man, I imagine how life would be if everyone was in tune to the same beat. We are blessed by Mother Nature, creator of colors and seas. And I'm grateful and I'm blessed to have entered this enchanted forest called nature.
If anyone here, respond by saying yes. Do you guys know English? Is anyone here? Is anyone here with us? Oh my god. Oh my god, I'm not moving it.
Well, obviously I'm moving it, Danny. It's fake, man.
God, why do you have to do this?
Hey, what's up, Danny? What you doing? I just want to tell you that there's been like crazy stuff going on around my house. Like the other day, I was hearing like strange noises, and I saw something move. And I think it was because of that game we played. I think something actually happened.
I was watching TV, a book fell, even though it was like around the middle of the table, so I was just like suspicious.
It was probably because I made fun of it or something. I don't know, but I feel like we need to finish that game. So like, you need to come over, like, now.
Be right there, soon.
Here we go. Okay, he's spinning. Oops. Is anyone here with us?
Whoa.
Are you the one that's been following us?
Whoa.
You know you messed up my room, right? Can you leave us alone? It wasn't a choice. I said leave us alone. Did you hear?
Yep, I heard that. I'm gonna go.
You took your hands off. You're not supposed to take your hands off.
It'll be real quick.
Danny. 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 Danny, what time? Oh. What the? Danny, for real, dude, this isn't funny. What the? Danny. What? I was just here. What are you talking? Okay. Oh, oh, oh.
Have you ever been writing and just wondered if you spelt something wrong? Well, there's a solution to that. Spell corrector spray. This sprays your bad spelling away. The product comes with two easy steps. Just spray and wipe. Wow, look at that magic. Spell corrector spray at your nearest Walmart.
Spell correctors were because I'm not really good at it, and I was always making mistakes on my essays and my school worksheets, and I'm surprised there's not even a way to do it on your computer to fix that. So once I found out about spell corrector spray, I had to buy it because I was so embarrassed about my spelling mistakes, and I'm so glad I did. And let me show you guys how it works. I have to spray it right here, and I'm about to put it on my screen right now.
Now you see how I spelled this word wrong, and I'm about to spray it up and fix it.
And you see right there, it fixed the word.
I bought the spell corrector spray, and this spray literally fixed all my spelling problems. I no longer have to worry about spelling. This product is a win. If you buy this, you will be satisfied. I'm gonna show you how it works. Spell corrector spray, and I'm gonna show you how it works. So you're just gonna give it a little spray like that, and when it dries, this, all your spelling should be fixed. So it's been a couple hours and look, everything is spelled correctly.
Hello everybody, my name is Jesus Ramirez. I am the co-founder of Kids Fun Times and inventor of the Magic Dolphin. Today, I'm here to tell you why you should invest in our Magic Dolphin. Magic Dolphin isn't just a product, it's a friend, it's a sleeping buddy. It's anything you want it to be. I worked for it. Here's some words from our happy customers.
Ever since I got the Magic Dolphin, my entire life has changed. Magic Dolphin hasn't only been my best purchase, but it became my best friend.
He helps me with homework. He does my laundry. Really is everything you could ask for.
This product is also a little off. I catch it looking at me a lot in a very creepy way while I play video games, while I lay down. I've also caught it using my computer.
Are you happy? Well, let me tell you something. You're not, so get that out of here. Not if you don't own a Magic Dolphin. Buy one today for only $800. Buy one, get one free for the price of two. Now that's a steal. That's like double the friendship right there. And who doesn't want double friends, right?
This product is very dangerous. It's not for kids under the age of 8. For your safety, never be alone in the same room with the Magic Dolphin.
Kids Fun Time is not responsible for any injuries that occur by the Magic Dolphin. Purchase the Magic Dolphin at your own risk.
Magic Dolphin is banned in several countries.
I'm also talking really fast while you don't understand the dangers.
you sad, depressed,
well, that sucks.
But don't fear, the never-ending ice cream is here. The never-ending ice cream is convenient to share when having none of your friends over. It can also be used when making desserts for your loved ones. Or you could just eat it because you're lonely and food is the only thing that can comfort you. The never-ending ice cream also comes in an assortment of flavors such as banana blue, savory strawberry, chunky chocolate, and very vanilla. Customers say it's the best tasting ice cream around.
So, what are you waiting for? Go on and order now and we'll throw in another ice cream tub for twice the amount. Have you always wanted a cat, but you couldn't get one because it was too expensive? Well now, with this cheap alternative, you can! With Spray It Meow! Spray It Meow is the new technology that lets you to get a cat in your very home, just by spraying it. Here, come on, I'll show you. All you do with the Spray It Meow is to shake the bottle, spray it 3 times, and suddenly there will be a cat there. And just like that, there's a cat on your couch. Look how excited it is.
The colors.
Comes in black, tuxedo. Comes in this marvelous gray color.
This color looks like cinnamon raisin bread.
And so much more. Words from our customers.
I love Spray It Meow. I love that I can spray it anywhere and get a kitty.
Let's hear another customer.
I absolutely love Spray It Meow. You don't understand, sir. You don't understand. I love Spray It Meow more than I love my husband. And I have 5 different cats in my home. Pardon my language. I'm just so excited. And I love my cat baby so much. You don't understand, so you don't understand. But yeah, I totally recommend Spray It Meow. If you want to love something more than your deadbeat husband, I recommend this.
Do you feel unattractive?
Yes.
Are you always dehydrated?
Yes.
May I interest you with some water?
Okay.
Then have this. Go on. Bottoms up.
Wow. I felt nothing.
What this man just tasted was nothing more but the best water on planet Earth. Bottled here at the source. And our scientist has found that this water can cure cancer, but further testing has proven this completely false. But wait, there's more! And for a limited time offer, if you call now, you'll receive smarter water. What are you waiting for? Order your bottle now. Do not drink if you're experiencing symptoms of dying.
Are you tired of drinking out of those boring cups?
I mean, it's just a cup.
No, you idiot. It's a boring cup. What you need is a magic cup.
What's a magic cup?
Are you always this dumb? A magic cup has magic.
So you mean I can be a wizard now?
What kind of clown school did you go to?
This one.
Oh, I get it now. Anyway, do you want the magic cup or not? Am I getting paid enough for this?
Sure.
The magic cup is built to take heavy falls. It can even regenerate itself. It also has the amazing ability to hold water. Call the number on the screen to buy the magic cup for $9.99.
Hello.
Are you feeling down? Depressed even? Feeling like your look is less than the average beauty standard? Yes? Well, I suggest you try one of our new line of new innovative makeup from Lilith Satanas Cosmetics. Here at Lilith Satanas Cosmetics, we formulate our products with the best ingredients, like sugar, spice, everything nice, and the occasional lead. See how our foundation glides against the skin, bringing out that natural skin tone? Our lip liners accentuate the lips by making them either smaller or bigger, depending on your preference. Accompanied by our cream lipsticks that come in the colors Noir Black, Raven Black, Midnight Black, Vampire Black, and the original Black. As a company, we strive for our customers to use and accentuate their looks to the very fullest. And for the modest price of $666,000 plus your insignificant soul, you get this whole collection plus our signature black cream lipstick travel sized for free. So what are you waiting for? Call in now at 222-666-1313. And remember, a scar on the hand may be quite continental, but Lilith is his best friend.
Tell me again about how it hurts being awfully loud for an introvert. Get out of my room. Smile wiped clean. Isn't it weird to be so mean? I'm guessing that I've grown horns. I guess I'm human no more. I can tell I've rotted in your brain. Oh, how easily passion twists. You think I'm a crazy bitch. I craft my words to fit your head, 'cause no one listens to the dead. So maybe I will talk to you. The only way I know how to. I've said my speech. Through sharpened teeth, you break the rules and spikes grow from your skin. Please let the devil in. A meter apart, we blankly said, we shout in our heads, are you still in there? Well, this ends bad then. We knew it would, so we won't eat our words, 'cause they don't taste good. I'm guessing that I've grown horns. I guess I'm human no more. I can tell I've rotted in your brain. Oh, how easily passion twists. You think I'm a crazy bitch. 1,000 words are left unsaid, 'cause no one listens to the dead. So maybe I will talk to you. The only way I know how to. I've said my speech. Through sharpened teeth, you break the rules and spikes grow from your skin. Oh, maybe worth a try. Oh, am I ready to let this die? A monster's here. You plug your ears, but hey, you might just listen to it sing. Please let the devil in. Adoring every move, and my rank is sinking. But we're both guilty of black or white thinking. Deep in my red eyes, it look pale. All of your scars are looking more like scales. Two ugly creatures, two sinister creatures, blind to the past like a couple of monsters. Just
just a couple of monsters. So maybe I will talk to you. The only way I know how to. You set your speech through sharpened teeth. You break the rules and spikes grow from your skin. Monsters here, you plug your ears, but hey, you might just listen to it sing. Please let the devil in.
Pack it, box it, flip it, top it. Hail Mary, catch me slipping through the concrete. Show no mercy, step right on me. Stiletto death, send me to purgatory. The bakery, trying to make some more. They expect me to stay when I should go. Grab the bag for when I cross the door. It ain't for me to roll it out, it's just for me to raise the cup. Cookie box, I flip it, top it with the bow tie. Fibbing, stop it, eating all the rainbow cookies. Pies are flying through the roof. All the cherry, the way they all go. Knock them down like she a dodgeball. Little mess up and she's angry. One downfall, she blamed the whole team. Pack it, box it, flip it, top it. Pack it, box it, flip it, top it. The bakery, tryna make some more. They expect me to stay.
¿Dónde está Vanessa? Es la pregunta que se le hizo al gobierno y no nos dan respuestas. ¿Será porque nos están escondiendo algo o no les interesa? Pues como la víctima es de piel morena, a ellos en nada les afecta. Tratan de deportarnos. Cuando estas tierras fueron nuestras y aún así las seguimos trabajando. Como animales a nuestros niños en jaulas los tienen encerrados. Sin corazón destruyendo a nuestras familias, tratando de separarnos. Esto tiene que cambiar, tenemos que despertar. O nos tratan con respeto, nos damos a respetar. Tenemos que alzar la voz para que puedan escuchar. Y aquí nadie es más que nadie. Exigimos igualdad. Y hay que levantar la voz, raza. Que no seas demasiado. Exigimos igualdad. Porque nadie hace nada. Si todas las vidas son importantes, porque chingan a mi raza. Ya me cansé de ver cómo nos humillan y cómo nos maltratan. Pues nosotros siempre estamos para dar la mano y ustedes nos dan la espalda. No me malinterpreten, pues como dice el dicho, el respeto se le da a quien lo merece. Y es que me duele un chingo ver sufrir a mí, gente inocente. Esa gente que día a día humildemente exigimos igualdad.
Ooh, ooh, ooh. algún día te vas de casa, yo te llevo a la NASA.
I'm 7 years old.
Pido un cohete y voy directo por ti. Y si no estoy y algo te pasa, recuerda que toda la vida cambia. Y no importa lo que pase, te prometo no faltarte. Me siento grande por ti, y aunque lo intentara no podría sin ti. Toda mi felicidad es gracias a ti, y si yo me muero volvería por ti. Me siento grande por ti, y aunque lo intentara no podría sin ti. Toda mi felicidad es gracias a ti, y si yo me muero volvería por ti, por ti. Se quedan cortas las palabras realmente, y a Dios le doy gracias porque estás aquí presente. Quiero que sepas que te amo eternamente, que cuando dije sí lo dije para siempre. A tu lado todo no es perfecto pero sí mejor, y cada detalle tuyo es mejor que el anterior. Aquella canción, y cuando decoras con rosas mi habitación. Vamos a enseñarle al mundo lo que es amor, tú y yo podemos juntos, porque amo todas las locuras de tu mente, y así me encanta presumirte ante la gente. Me siento grande por ti, y aunque lo intentara no podría sin ti. Toda mi felicidad es gracias a ti, y si yo me muero volvería por ti. Me siento grande por ti, y aunque lo intentara no podría sin ti. Toda mi felicidad es gracias a ti, y si yo me muero volvería por ti.
Oh,
kicking your style when I'm pulling you underground. Take a sip on the devil's cup just to keep you on good enough. Feel the fit when you swallow up. Let me in. I'm moving when you like.
Cheers. told me, babe, someday these will be the good old days. All the love you forget, and all these reckless nights you regret. Someday soon your whole life's gonna change. You'll miss the magic of these good old days.
I was thinking about the band, I was thinking about the fans. We were underground, loading merch in that 12 passenger van. In a small club in Minnesota, and the snow outside of First Ave. I just wanted my name and a star. Now look at where we at, still growing up. Still growing up. I would lay in my bed and dream about what I'd become. Couldn't wait to get older. Couldn't wait to be some. Now that I'm here, wishing I was still young.
Told me, babe, that someday these would be the good old days. All the love you won't forget, and all these reckless nights you won't regret. Cause someday soon your whole life's gonna change. You'll miss the magic of the good old.
Thank you. Who thinks all the time has nothing to think about except thoughts. So he loses touch with reality and lives in a world of illusions. By thoughts I mean specifically chatter in the skull, perpetual and compulsive repetition of words, of reckoning and calculating. I'm not saying that thinking is bad. Like everything else, it's useful in moderation. A good servant, but a bad master. And all so-called civilized peoples have increasingly become crazy and self-destructive because through excessive thinking they have lost touch with reality. That's to say, we confuse science with the real world. This is the beginning of meditation.
your name?
Maria Virginia Bravo.
Where are you born?
Mexicali, Baja California.
Su nombre. Jesús Bugarín.
Where were you born?
¿Y dónde nació?
Nací en la Unión de Tula, Jalisco.
María Eunice Bonilla.
Where were you born?
¿Dónde nació?
En la Ciudad de México.
Where did you grow up?
En Mexicali.
How old were you when you crossed the border?
19 years.
Where did you grow up?
¿Dónde creció?
En Santa María de Los Ángeles, Jalisco. How old were you when you crossed the border?
¿Cuántos años tuvo cuando cruzó la frontera?
Tenía 30.
En Jalisco, México.
How old were you when you crossed the border?
¿Cuántos años tenía cuando cruzó la frontera?
19 años.
¿Qué se le dijo alguien que se iba a ir o más se fue?
My mom. Sure. I tell it to my mom. When he coming in here.
Okay.
When he crossed to the border.
Sí.
¿Le hizo saber a su familia que se iba o simplemente se fue?
No, sí, sí le sabes, ¿eh?
¿Le hizo saber a su familia que se fue o simplemente se fue?
Venía con mis padres.
What were the dates when you traveled to the U.S. from your home country?
16, September 15 de 77.
¿Se acuerda las fechas donde se viajó a los Estados Unidos desde su país?
Sí, como el 68.
¿Cuáles son las fechas de cuando se viajó a los Estados Unidos desde su país?
Como, yo creo como el 10 de enero de 68 al 26 de enero.
Did you travel alone or with a group of people?
Group to the people.
Sí. Did you leave anyone behind?
Sí, dejó alguien atrás.
Only my family, for my brother, my sister, my mom, no more.
¿Viajó solo o con un grupo de personas?
Solo. No, con un grupo de personas para pasar.
Sí.
Did you leave anyone behind?
¿Dejó alguien atrás?
No.
¿Viajó sola o con un grupo de personas?
Con mi familia.
Did you have to leave anyone behind?
Con mis hermanos y mis papás.
¿Dejó alguien atrás?
No.
Did you have any difficulties when you were traveling? Like...
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Like, did you get lost or run out of food, comida?
Yeah, I crossed for the river. We throw in stone in the river. You see, it's the least in the water, and we can cross. Íbamos por el río, pero por la orilla eran como un canal de aguas negras. Y aventábamos piedras y si se oía que había agua, que corría agua, no nos íbamos más para abajo, pero en la noche nos íbamos agarrando de los árboles, de las ramas, de lo que había, con peligro de agarrar un alacrán, una araña, pero así íbamos.
¿Cuántas dificultades tuvo que enfrentar mientras viajaba?
Unas dos, tres veces.
Por ejemplo,
no podía pasar.
Por ejemplo, se perdió.
Me regresaba, ¿no?
¿Cuáles dificultades tuvo que le pasó viajando? Por ejemplo, ¿se perdió o se quedó sin comer?
Ninguna. Ninguna dificultad.
Did you ever get robbed?
¿La robaron o la asaltaron?
Me quitaron todo cuando yo crucé para acá, los coyotes me quitaron todas mis identificaciones y todos mis papeles.
¿Alguna vez lo robaron?
Sí.
No.
¿Alguna vez la gente le trató de robarla? No.
Did you ever get caught and sent back to your home country?
Sí, la cacharon ilegalmente y la regresaron para atrás.
Nunca.
¿Para atrás a su país?
No.
¿Que sí?
No.
¿Pasó ilegalmente?
No.
¿O que la mandaron para atrás?
No.
¿Qué es lo que hizo cuando llegó a los Estados Unidos?
Lo puro trabajar y trabajar. Trabajar en restaurantes, en el fil, en la fresa, en la lechuga, en todo.
¿Qué hizo ya que llegó al país de los Estados Unidos?
Aquí, a trabajar.
¿Qué hizo cuando llegó aquí a los Estados Unidos?
Trabajar en los campos de California y Arizona.
What made you leave your home country?
¿Qué es lo que le hizo que se vaya de su país de origen? Esa pregunta. ¿Qué le hizo que se vaya?
Mi hermana, porque yo en realidad nunca quise estar aquí.
Okay. ¿Qué la hizo ir o huirse de su país?
No venía huyendo. Venía para... Es que mi madre es nacida aquí en Estados Unidos y venía para con ella. Ella me trajo.
What type of difficulties did you face in the U.S. while trying to adjust to American life?
¿Qué dificultades tuvo usted aquí en Estados Unidos para ajustar a la vida de aquí, en Estados Unidos?
Me quedé porque mis hijos nacieron aquí.
¿Qué tipo de dificultades tuvo que enfrentar mientras se adaptaba a la vida de los Estados Unidos?
Ninguna, solo puse a trabajar.
¿Cuáles tipos de dificultades tuvo usted aquí en los Estados Unidos en tiempo de crecer aquí en la vida de los Estados Unidos?
No tuve dificultades, solo buscar trabajo.
¿Home country or do you miss your home?
¿Viviendo aquí en Estados Unidos es mejor o es mejor viviendo en su país de su origen? ¿Y extraña su país de origen?
Me tuve que ver forzada a adaptarme a vivir aquí porque mis hijos nacieron aquí. Pero si yo no hubiera tenido ni un hijo aquí, yo me hubiera quedado en México.
¿Tú sí extraña su país?
Sí.
Okay. ¿Es mejor viviendo aquí en los Estados Unidos que en su país?
Sí.
¿Extraña su país?
No.
¿Viviendo en los Estados Unidos es mejor que viviendo en su país? ¿Y extraña su país?
Extraño mi país, pero viviendo aquí hay mejores oportunidades de trabajar y de vivir diferente.
Your name.
Mi nombre es
Claudia Vargas. ¿Cómo te llamas?
Gustavo Núñez. Yo nací en la ciudad de Guadalajara, México.
From Guanajuato, México. ¿Dónde eres?
De Copala, Jalisco, México.
And what year do you immigrate to the US?
Nosotros inmigramos porque queríamos mi papá nos trajo para una mejor vida.
Why year do you immigrate to the US?
Para tener una mejor vida aquí en los Estados Unidos.
¿En cuál año te viniste a los Estados Unidos?
En el 92.
Do you came by yourself?
Ah, sí.
Do you come by yourself?
No.
¿Te viniste solo?
Con mi hermana y una tía, sí.
What do your family think of you immigrating?
Porque siempre ellos querían, especialmente mis papás, querían una mejor vida para mí y para mis hermanos.
What do your family think of you immigrating?
Más mucha felicidad porque va a haber más oportunidades y mejor vida aquí que en México.
¿Qué pensó su familia de usted emigrando?
Pues se pusieron tristes porque los niños son terrenos desconocidos.
Were you scared to immigrate?
No, nunca tuve miedo de venir a otro país. Al contrario, siempre tenía ganas de emigrar a este gran país.
Were you scared to immigrate?
Pues no, yo no, estaba un poco más chica, pero mis papás sí.
¿Y luego a emigrar?
En parte sí y en parte no, por el no lo conocía suficiente personas aquí.
Why do you want to come to the US?
Why?
Why?
Porque siempre pensé que en este país hay más oportunidades que en México.
Why do you want to come to the US?
Ellos querían venir para darnos una mejor vida y mejor educación.
¿Por qué quiso venir a los Estados Unidos?
Para mejorar y dar un mejor...
Sí, el idioma. El idioma siempre ha sido el challenge más grande que he tenido.
Do you face any challenges in immigrating?
Mis papás sí, para poder evitar la inmigración y que los fueran a deportar.
¿Algún desafío al inmigrar?
Sí, los peligros. La señora que venía conmigo se cayó y se lastimó sus...
Were you able to overcome these challenges?
Sí, hoy en este día soy bilingüe, hablo inglés y español, pero quizás eso fue lo más difícil al emigrar a este país.
Were you guys able to overcome these challenges?
Sí, se hicieron residentes de aquí de Estados Unidos.
¿Fueron capaces de superar estos desafíos?
Sí, más difícil.
Do you ever thought of giving up and go back to your city?
No, jamás. Nunca di por rendirme. Siempre supe que aquí habría una vida mucho más mejor para mí, para mi familia.
Do you ever thought of giving up and go back to your own city?
No.
¿Alguna vez pensó en rendirse y volver a su ciudad?
No, porque aquí tengo mejor vida que allá.
When you got to the US, how do you feel?
Un poco triste porque dejaba a miembros de mi familia en mi país, pero una vez que me fui acostumbrando fue todo mucho más mejor.
When you got to the US, how do you feel?
Ellos se sentían un poco asustados y tristes a la vez, porque dejaban sus padres allá en México y sus familiares.
Cuando llegó a los Estados Unidos, ¿cómo se sintió?
Los primeros días tristes, después me acostumbré y me puse más alegre.
When you got to the US, do you face any challenges?
El idioma y quizás el no conocer tanta gente y la cultura, que es mucho más diferente que la de México.
When you got to the US, do you face any challenges?
Ellos sí, el lenguaje y el no poder conseguir donde vivir.
¿Tenías algún desafío aquí en los Estados Unidos?
Hasta ahorita no.
Do you have any family in the US already?
Sí, ahorita hoy en día pues toda mi familia está aquí, mis papás, mis hermanos, todos están aquí.
Do you have any family in the US already?
Mis papás sí, tenían algunos hermanos y unos tíos.
¿Tenías familia en los Estados Unidos? How was your experience being an immigrant, finding a job and a place to live?
Bueno, hoy en día para mí quizás fue un poco más fácil porque mis papás junto con mis hermanos me dieron educación. Hoy en este día tengo un buen trabajo gracias a que me pude graduar de la high school y pude terminar un poco de colegio.
How was your experience being an immigrant, finding jobs and a place to live?
Se les dificultó a ellos mucho porque no sabían el idioma, no tenían un carro, cómo moverse.
¿Cómo fue su experiencia siendo inmigrante, buscando trabajo y un lugar para vivir?
La experiencia, pues a mí me contestó la oportunidad que mis familiares me ayudaron a conseguir un trabajo y me dieron vivienda.
¿Es mejor vivir here than your own country?
Oh sí, mucho más mejor vivir aquí que en México en todos los sentidos. En el trabajo, en lo que ganas, en las oportunidades, tanto para ti como para tus hijos.
Is it better to live here than your own country?
Sí, porque aquí es más oportunidades y aquí es una educación mejor.
Okay, thank you. ¿Viviendo aquí en este país es mejor que tu ciudad?
Sí.
So, where in the Philippines were you born?
I was born in Capas, Tarlac, Philippines. That is in Luzon.
How was life in the Philippines like?
Life in the Philippines was different. You know, there's 6 of us, and then my parents adopted 2 more. So it was really a big family. And we live in one house with my grandma, my parents, and my grandma. and I went to the elementary grades over there, at Capas Elementary School. And then high school, I went to Tarlac, to a private school, Holy Ghost Institute. And college, I went to the Far Eastern University, Manila, Philippines. I graduated in the College of Law. I was a lawyer in 1961, practiced law in the Philippines, became a district attorney, and we migrated in the United States April of 1970.
How was school life in the Philippines?
Well, in the Philippines, when you're going to school, it's just school and home, library. There's no socializing, unlike here in the United States where there's a lot of socializing. What I remember the most is that I just concentrated in going to school because that's the only way to do it. We did not work because there's no jobs if you are just a high school graduate. So I finished my law degree in 6 years.
Were you well known amongst your classmates?
Was I popular? Mm-hmm. Oh, very popular. I was in the top 10. I was a member of the Far Eastern University Student Catholic Action. I was a member of a sorority, Delta Lambda. And I was also in the editorial staff. I was in the top 10 of the class. I married young. I was just starting my law degree when I got married. And then I had my baby when I was in still school. I remembered when I had my baby at Far Eastern University Hospital, my professor, Senator Ponce, Juan Ponce Enrile, who is my labor laws professor, canceled the class and he took the whole class to the hospital and visited me. That's how popular I was.
So after school, what was your job occupation back in the Philippines?
Okay, I practiced law for a few years and then afterwards I was appointed as a district attorney in Anguilla City when it became a city. I was the district attorney until we migrated in the United States April of 1970.
Go on any trips outside the Philippines?
When I was in the Philippines, no, it was all work because I have a lot of children. There was no time for leisure. It was just work and the children. I had 6 children at that time in the Philippines before we left. Then I had one more in Wisconsin, so a total of 7 children. So there was really no time for leisure. It was just work, work, work until we migrated in the United States where, you know, I'm more relaxed. I did not practice law in the United States. I just was a regular employee.
Were there any accomplishments you made back in the Philippines?
Well, I think being a lawyer is quite an accomplishment. I was the only woman lawyer in the Philippines, in Anguilla City, I mean. And when I became a district attorney, there were, at that time in the 60s, there were no streetlights. And I was like a queen, you know, when the policemen, who are patrolling the streets will see me, they stop the traffic and so I can pass, you know. So that was quite an accomplishment, being the only lawyer, being a district attorney, a woman. At that time in the 60s was quite an accomplishment. I think I could not ask for anything more. I've done it. I've done everything, you know, and having been married, having children, and still was able to practice my profession. That's quite an accomplishment for me.
How did you meet Grandpa?
I met him when I was 16 years old. He was a friend of my parents, and he was teaching my parents ballroom dancing, and my parents introduced me to him, and that was the start of him courting me, and I became the queen in the hometown, and he saw that I was already like an adult, you know. He was 10 years older than me. He was already a doctor when I met him. He was practicing in the city where I was born. That's how I met him.
Did your parents like Grandpa?
Very much, you know. He was their friend. He was more their friend than mine, you know. They were the one introducing him to me. And so he was were like my parents.
Have you heard anything about the U.S. before traveling?
Have I heard about the United States before I came? Oh yeah, definitely. As a matter of fact, my husband wanted to come here after he graduated from medical school because he did not like the practice in the United States, I mean in the Philippines. He wanted to migrate right away to the United States until he met me. But I have, you know, I was young and I had my own ambitions. I wanted to become a lawyer. And so he waited for me. I really did not want to come here in the United States because I knew life here will be different. For me, it will be hard because I will not have the maids that I had in the Philippines. I was wondering how I can practice my law degree here. And it took a long, long time before I decided I wanted to come here. It took martial law to convince me that I should already come with my husband in the United States and bring my children here.
What made you make the choice to move to the U.S.?
As I've said, you know, the government is not stable anymore in the Philippines. It was the martial law was starting. As a district attorney, my life was not safe anymore. I was getting threats, letters, saying that if I don't do certain things, my family is threatened. So my husband and I decided, you know, it's time to move to the United States. And I'm glad I did make that move because, you know, our life here is different.
What was your experience moving here?
At first it was hard. From nothing, and then you start all over again. My husband did not have his license to practice in the United States. He had to take all the examinations from internship to residency. In my case, I lost my license to practice law. I took the bar exams here. I missed it by less than 1%. It wasn't meant to be. I work in banking. I became vice president and manager of Wells Fargo Bank. And then after, in 1989, December 1989, I decided to leave banking. On January 1st, 1990, I decided to start my own business, Farmers Insurance, and I was with the company for 25 years until I retired when I was 75 years old.
Did you like your jobs here in the U.S.?
It was a challenge, you know. I mean, at first, it was hard because, you know, from being somebody in the Philippines to nobody here in the United States, it was a challenge. As a matter of fact, when I first started working in Wisconsin at the M&I Bank, every time we have a break, you know, I cry because I was nobody, I was nothing, you know. I have to follow the supervisor, whatever she wants. In the Philippines, I had secretaries. I have people under me. There are deputy district attorneys under me. I was the boss, and here I was nobody. So it was really hard. And then I you know, being as ambitious as I am, you know, I rose from the ranks until I became vice president and manager of Wells Fargo Bank in California. Then again, you know, then it was a different story after that. After that, I was successful in my own right.
What was life in the U.S. like when you first came here?
It was very hard, having six children. And I remember at that time, you know, my salary was only $275 a month from the bank. That was really hard. And my husband was working at the hospital, but not as a doctor. I think he was just like an assistant physician or something. And we were living in a two-bedroom house. Thank God that they allowed all this, the kids I have. And then I have my parents with me because they have to come and help me take care of the children. So it was, I can say it was from rags to riches. It was really a struggle. You know, we have to sacrifice. The kids have to sacrifice. Thank God they were still small when they came. They did not need much.
So, if you're gonna do everything over again, would you have made the choice to move to the US or do anything different about your life?
Definitely, I'll do the same thing. You know, when at first, as I've said, you know, I struggled to make a decision to come here in America. It took a long, long time, many, many years before my husband was able to convince me to come here. As I've said, you know, I was very, very successful in the Philippines. I left all that to sacrifice for my children, but then I'm glad I did, and even my children are thanking me now that, you know, I decided to move here. It would have been a different life if we were still in the Philippines. So I will not change anything. It's probably just a matter. I should probably have decided to move earlier. But then, you know, God has plans for everything in your life, you know. So I leave it up to God. Whatever happened, I think is for the better, is for the good.
What is your name?
My name is Bertha Perez.
Where were you born?
I was born in Michoacán, Mexico.
What is your relation to me?
Oh, you're my grandson.
How was life before you came?
I don't remember because I was too young.
At what age did you come to the U.S.?
Between 2 and 3 years old.
What made you come?
Well, my parents brought me over.
Were you separated from your family?
No.
What was the border that you crossed from?
I'm thinking that it's Tijuana, Mexico.
What was your first trip inside the United States?
Inside the United States, well, we probably came to Salinas.
Did you ever regret coming to the United States?
Oh, no.
What is your name? Where were you born? What is your relation to me? At what age did you come to the U.S.? What was your first trip in the U.S.? What was life like before you came? What is your name?
Rachel Trevino.
Where were you born?
Monterrey, Nuevo León, Mexico.
What is your relation to me?
I am your mother.
How was life like before you came?
Hard.
At what age did you come to the United States?
At 8 years old.
What made you come to the United States?
To change.
Were you separated from your family?
Yes, my mother.
How did you come to the United States?
My uncle drove us over here in the car.
What border did you cross from?
Tijuana, Mexico.
And what was your first trip inside the United States?
To the Santa Cruz Beach Boardwalk.
Do you ever regret coming to the United States?
No, never.
Goodbye, Arena!
happy to tell you what I know.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Fortnite Tonight Show. We have a very special guest today, so let's get right into it and introduce them. So, our guest tonight is very, very, very famous. Would you like to go ahead and introduce yourself, sir?
Well, my name is Minecraft Steve, but you could call me Steve or Stevie or I don't know. I don't know. Why am I here? You have any you got some questions for me? I believe.
So, how long have you been working in the industry?
I've been working for about 13 years, you know, I've been out here on that Minecraft grind doing the same thing for 13 years straight. Yeah, it's a toll on me, but I'm pushing through, you know.
As a video game industry veteran myself, working in the industry for...
you cannot speak on the industry. You've only been here for like 5 years or less.
I've been here for like five years.
You took everything from me.
I mean, you're still. I mean, you're like the most famous person on the planet. I think your game sold like. I think he's the most sold game. I think right now, currently. My game's like popular too. I guess. How's your game been lately? Have you been getting any cool updates? I guess Minecraft hasn't been getting any updates. Well, I guess that was all the time our guest had. Let's just cut to the musical accompaniment, whatever the word is. Let's cut to them now. That's some pretty good music, eh? How about a little short comedy sketch in public? That would be funny, huh? Let's go watch that. Ah, what a fine day in this pizza parlor. Hello, sir. Can I help you today?
Yo, I'd like a quarter pounder with cheese, bacon, lettuce, and onions.
You can have this.
Yo, I don't want no pizza, dog.
Let me check in the back. You can have this.
How much for a bag of Doritos?
Ouch. That Dorito costs like $2.50.
I'm taking it, thank you.
Alright.
I solved your problem.
Thanks. You can have this.
Did I say I wanted a pizza?
Don't hurt me. I work minimum wage, please. No! Ah, I'm stuck! It burns! It burns!
Get back here, Bobby!
Hi everyone, it's me, Sage, and we're gonna be playing Elder Scrolls V Skyrim. It's a open world RPG that was developed by Bethesda. So today we will be getting some mammoth meat and such. There's my housekeeper, Calder, and then these are my two daughters, along with their fox named Kit. You just watches her sleep, I guess. So we're gonna be leaving our house and going outside. Ow. So, I'm a vampire. My vampire blood boils in the sunlight. So, we'll be leaving Windhelm and we're gonna be going to look for a mammoth. Our plans might change. Who knows? Maybe there's some wolves, maybe there's a dragon. Who knows? Excuse me. So, I'll be out here. In our beautiful world that is Skyrim. And we will be heading out. So we're walking. And walking. And walking.
Where'd you come from?
What? Oh, jeez. And we got attacked by a saber cat. Okay. So that happened. Anywho. Is that a dragon? Is there a dragon nearby? That's a dragon. Over here, let's go check it out. Oh geez, that's a hag. That's a hag. Today we'll be fighting a lot, folks. We'll be fighting many things. And she's gone. Though I am incredibly slow. That is definitely a dragon. Where is it? I am not sure. So I'll be right back to find the dragon. As you can see, I found the dragon, so let's go kill it. Hello, you big flying chicken. You big giant reptilian pigeon. Get over here. Fight me. Oh, jeez. Hello? Oh, jeez. It's in my head. It's in my head. Hello? Where did it go? Oh, hello? Okay, then. I got hurt. Let us... Alright, dragon fighting time. Jesus Christ, I just got. Yay, we killed it! Isn't that amazing? Wow! Now give me your soul, dragon. I'm the dragonborn, you hear? I guess not. We got dragon bone, dragon skills, and some money. Yay! I think we're gonna stop that here, folks. We went through a lot. Though we didn't find mammoths, we found a hag, a saber cat, and we killed the dragon. Isn't that right, Serena? So, I hope you guys have a wonderful day, and goodbye.
Whoa, where am I? How did I get here? Oh, what is this? Running shoes? No, running boots? Okay.
I don't think you have any idea how fast I really am.
Okay, let's come out to find some materials and build a house.
We are the music makers, and we are the dreamers of dreams.
Hello everybody, today
we're gonna be playing some Minecraft. So my name is Sir Humphrey II, and basically Minecraft is an open world game where you pretty much build, do what you want. Really, your mind is the limit. Sky's the limit when it comes to Minecraft. There is an ending to it, but today we're not going to be doing that. Today, my objective is to simply find some diamonds. Might be quite tough, might be quite easy. Who knows, but I know I'm going to be setting this on hard. So, let's go. Alright, so I spawned into this world. Seems pretty cool, seems pretty cool. I'm pretty excited to start off. This is my first Minecraft game in a while, so... let's go! We should probably get some wood first, you know. Yeah, but wood is pretty good, it's pretty good, it's pretty good. Chopping up some wood. Gotta build myself some materials. Maybe a house, who knows? This is going pretty well so far. I haven't died yet, so that's a plus. Yeah, this is pretty fun, not gonna lie. Alright, so welcome to my first Minecraft world. I'm gonna be starting off with some wood. I don't know what happened there, ignore that. Let's chop up some wood, people. We gotta get this going if we're gonna have to find those diamonds. Yeah, this is a pretty fun world. It's a pretty fun world. It's really nice. I'm really enjoying this game. It's a pretty fun game. Yeah. Alright guys, I found myself some wood and pretty much made planks, so... we should start getting going on that house. Maybe build a crafting table, I don't know. Honestly, I don't know what I'm doing. But let's start. Let's build myself a crafting table. Yes! We should probably build some materials as well. Aw, yeah, this is really taking off. Let's go. I don't know why I built a shuffle, but... alright. So our next objective is to, build ourselves a house, so... yeah, I'm probably gonna skip this, because it's gonna be a really long and tedious... process, so... I'll be back. Alright guys, after 3 hours of hard work, I have finally finished my house. So, let's check it out. Whoa! Very nice, very nice. Definitely did not look it up on YouTube, but it's pretty nice, I'd say. Get me through the night. So let's go inside, shall we? So this is the inside of my house. You see, it's pretty nice. I'm not gonna lie. Got my bed over here. We got a nice painting over there. We got an indoor pool. Oh yeah. What else we have? We got a bunch of chests here. Sir Theodore III right there. And a nice painting. I think I did a pretty good job. So now it's time to find those diamonds. Let's go. Alright guys, so right now I'm trying to find a good... Alright guys, it's been about 3 days, I think. Still no signs of diamonds anywhere. Ah, I'm beginning to lose all- Let's go, boys! Let's go! Let's go! Oh my god! No! We did it! We did it! Oh yeah! Oh, we did it, boys! We beat the game. Let's go. Now it's time to head back home. Oh!
Claudia.
And I am Grecia.
Today we are promoting an amazing artist who has been working on incredible commissions for y'all.
Now appreciate someone for artwork.
The type of commission you can get is half body and full body drawings with shade or flat color, as well as color with shade.
If you're wondering, she also does digital artworks, but the price for them might be a little bit higher than the traditional ones, since she mostly specializes on traditional art.
For more information and prices, go to tumblr.com and search on the search bar Jam Jar if you're interested to get a commission.
Letting the rabbit free time. Go, we'll be free.